being a principal. So
what is the principle now?
Leaders who are committed, mm-hmm. who are vision driven and results oriented, together with the mm-hmm. people who are, you know, who are fed up and want better.
But is the administration is responsive to this?
Yes, yes. The president supported the forum. He mm-hmm. knew about it. In fact, mm-hmm. he sent Butch to deliver his message. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And Butch said, you know, let's work out something wherein representatives of the organization or the, you know, reimagining mm-hmm. conveners or representatives of the group can have an audience with the president.
The other mm-hmm. thing that I'd like to mention is that we're establishing the Pinoy Power Institute.
That's right. Mm-hmm.
So that
People Power Institute.
Pinoy Power.
Pinoy
because
Power Institute. Yeah.
We were thinking
Pinoy spelled what?
P-I-N
or P-I?
No, P-I-N-O-Y. Yeah. Okay. Mainly because the People Power has some baggage that we also don't want to carry also, mm-hmm. The old People Power. Because whatever happens to what people talk about as a result of this conversation, and if it needs actionable agenda, then may sasalo na secretariat. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. at least may secretariat na magtutuloy.
To follow you up.
To follow it up.
Yeah. Kanina, in the makeup room, somebody said parang, ano yung word yun? Parang you're also happy about the conference.
There
is hangover. Very high, no, about it. Kaya lang, you know, some cynical people might say, yeah, we're always like that, you know, we're high about mm-hmm. something, or, mm-hmm. you know. How do we make sure,
you know, I've been
that this is not going to just
I've
dissipate.
Been an activist since 1980s. Uh-huh. You know, it's been 20 plus years. Somebody's got to do it. Mm-hmm. You know, we happen to be in a position to do something about it, and we're just going to keep at it.
Yeah.
And,
okay.
and for me, bottom line is this is what my children deserve.
Yeah.
I cannot betray my children or abandon them or leave them.
And I guess we're in a better position now than before, right?
Yeah.
I mean, we have that microfinance, for example, you know, etc.
To express it poetically, I read something in the internet, hindi ko alam ang source, pero sabi niya, there is a dream dreaming us.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, tayo'y panaginip ng ibang tao.
Mm-hmm.
Wala tayong autonomy, di ba? It's time we really dream our own dreams.
Tayo mm-hmm.
It's really, tayo talagang, ano, it's our future.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Wag na natin, ano, we're not part of a big scheme that's run by somebody. Mm-hmm. It's time we run it. Mm-hmm. Parang ganun ang tingin ko.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
In the same way that, you know, in the last election, people were saying, I am not going to allow the politicians to decide where this country is going to go.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They're not going to decide the future of my children. I will decide it. That's mm-hmm. what the people were saying in 2010. And that's my reading. That they're sick and tired of the old ways. They're looking for new things. They're looking for different approaches. They're looking for solutions. Mm-hmm. And they're saying, I am part of the solution, and I'm not going to allow some abusive, arrogant public official to tell me that this is the future for my children. No way. Mm-hmm. And that's the beauty of you know, people standing up and deciding, enough is enough, we're going to move things towards a new direction.
Mm-hmm. Okay. There was a tweet from Dean George Bokobo, tweets a Sagada son. He said, I like the indigenous dream mentioned by Marian, to be able to drink the water of the Pasig in 25 years.
Thank you, Dini.
Okay, final words, Marian Pastoros.
Well, I really appreciated the fact that all of the participants were not pie-in-the-sky thinkers.
Mm.
They can dream big, they can dream crazy, but they actually have a fairly good idea how it can get done.
Mm-hmm.
So I rest my hope on that. Mm-hmm. These are very practical and very pragmatic people, but dreamers nonetheless.
Mm-hmm.
So, maganda yung kombinasyon eh.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, thank you. Mark?
Yeah, I mean, I mentioned it earlier, but Filipinos, we're used to thinking about tomorrow, next day. Matlayo na yung next year eh.
Mm-hmm.
So, again, let's start really thinking about a longer horizon. It's the only way we can really progress. If we're only thinking about tomorrow, we'll just keep on taking incremental steps. But think about the moonshot. Think about that where the science does not yet exist.
Mm-hmm.
But let's go for that. Or else we won't go any, you know, we won't take a quantum leap forward. So
mm-hmm. Okay.
Longer horizon.
Thank you, Jim.
It's time we had really bigger plans for ourselves, di ba? Dapat ano, hindi tayo kuripot sa ano, mm-hmm. panaginip, di ba? Mm-hmm. Hindi tayo kuripot sa ambisyon, hindi tayo kuripot sa kung anong gusto natin mangyari. I mean, we don't have that time anymore. And you know, we have to inspire ourselves. We have to be the fire and breath of our own ano, momentum. Mm-hmm. Okay. Sa akin, importante yun.
Thank you. Senator Kiko?
Well, ako, I'm 47. So in 13 years, I'll be 60. And that's about retirement age already. It's the next generation's turn. So now is the time to really think about change, and now is the time to really look, you know, to the future and decide where we want the country to go, and how more importantly, how do we intend to get there? And again, I'll go back, and my final point: our people are resilient, are hardworking, are persevering, will sacrifice so much for their loved ones, their family, and if they are inspired, we can succeed. There's no reason why we cannot succeed in the next 25 years.
Okay. Thank you very much, Senator Kiko Pangilinan, Jim Paredes, Mark Ruiz, and Marian Pastor Roses. Maraming salamat. Thank you for being here. Join us again next Tuesday. I'm your host, Pio Ontiveros. Make sure it's nothing personal, strictly politics. Thank you. Good night.